A company estimates that sales will grow at a rate given by the function. S prime of t is the rate in thousands of dollars per month, and t is the number of months. We want to determine the accumulated sales for the first 2 months, and then determine the accumulated sales for the fourth month. So if we integrate the sales rate over an interval of time, it will tell us the accumulated sales. Let's take a look at this graphically. So to determine the accumulated sales for the first 2 months, if we integrate the given function over the interval from 0 to 2, it will give us the accumulated sales. So we want to determine the area of this region here under the function. To better illustrate why this area would give us the accumulated sales, we could represent a piece of this area using a rectangle as we see here. And for the area of this rectangle, we would multiply the width, which is the time in months, times the height, which is the sales rate, in 10,000s of dollars per month. So multiplying the time in months times the sales rate would give us the accumulated sales over that interval of time. So we'll have the definite integral from 0 to 2 of 0.1 e to the power of t integrated with respect to t. So we can pull this 0.1 out if we want. And the antiderivative of e to the t is just e to the t, so we'll have 0.1 times e to the t, and then we'll evaluate this at 2 and 0. So we'll have e squared minus e to the 0. Well, e to the 0 is equal to 1, so let's go to our calculator. 0.1 times e squared minus 1. So this is approximately 0.6389. But remember, the scale on the y-axis is by 10,000s. So to determine the accumulated sales, we'll have to multiply this by 10,000. So if we round to the nearest penny, this would be $6,389.06. Now this may not seem like a lot, but notice if the sales rate continues to grow as they anticipate, the accumulated sales will grow dramatically as well. Let's take a look at the second question. This question only wants the accumulated sales for the fourth month. So we have to be careful about our limits of integration. Notice from 0 to 1, that would be the first month. From 1 to 2 would be the second month. From 2 to 3 would be the third month. And then from 3 to 4 would be the fourth month. So to find the accumulated sales only for the fourth month, we're going to have to integrate from 3 to 4. And then, of course, the integrand will be the same. So now it's just like the previous example, except our limits of integration are different. And the antiderivative of e to the t is e to the t. Now we'll replace t with 4 and then t with 3 and then determine the difference. So we'll have e to the 4th minus e to the 3rd. And now we'll go back to the calculator. So it's approximately 3.451. Again, this would be the area on the interval from 0 to 3 under the function. But to determine the accumulated sales, we do need to recognize that the scaling on the y-axis is by 10,000s. So we have to multiply this by 10,000 to determine the accumulated sales for the fourth month. So it's approximately $34,512.61. So as we mentioned before, because the sales rate is growing so quickly, the accumulated sales are much larger as time passes. Notice for just this 1 month, the sales are over $34,000. But for the first 2 months, the sales were just over $6,000. We'll take a look at one more application of area under a function in the next video. I hope this was helpful.